And that brings us to the guy we talked about a couple episodes ago. Yeah. Cancun Cruz, Cancun everybody. Cruz. So this, I remember watching actually a little bit of this on Fox News as it was happening. And I remember seeing a Chiron. It was on mute, so I didn't actually hear him. But the Chiron on Fox News literally said, Ted Cruz, we can and must unite conservatives and libertarians over a shared love of liberty. And I was just like, oh, God, are we really doing this again, so, people? Have they not learned their lesson after 60 years that fusionism was a mistake?
So this goes back. This goes kind of goes back to what we mentioned a couple of episodes ago when we were talking about Cancun Cruz. Ted Cruz, he got elected in 2010.
2012, actually.
2012, yeah.
So 2 years late to the party.
Correct, yeah. He got elected in 2012. I was thinking 2010 because the Tea Party, that's when
he did ride the Tea Party wave, but after it was popular.
Yeah, he rode the Tea Party wave. He came, the only Senate candidate that I believe was endorsed by Ron Paul. And his whole, we got to remember, this is the age of Richard Dawkins. So this is when the new atheism was ascendant. And Ted Cruz was trying to fuse conservatism with the new atheist think, you know, the new atheists who are coming of age, the millennials, by trying to convince them that they just need to be libertarians. We can all share the same country. We can all live and let live if we just embrace libertarianism. And he hasn't quite moved on from that. You know, the new atheism just isn't in vogue anymore. Nobody cares at this point. Those people who supported that new atheistic movement in the early aughts, they have moved on. Like, they've become nationalists. Many of them have converted to Christianity. Many of them have just jumped on the progressive bandwagon. They've rode the, now they're a huge intersectionist. So Ted Cruz never really moved on from that moment. In his mind, it's like it's still 2010. So I will say this about Cruz. He's not a neocon. Like, he's not still stuck in the Bush era, stuck in the McCain era. He is a little bit past that, but he's still a decade behind the times.
And like we said, he still is trying to basically blend the Tea Party with the MAGA America First agenda. And that's just not gonna work, Ted. It's not gonna work. I'm telling you. And that was perfectly personified by this part of his speech.
We don't believe in uniformity, but I'll tell you what can unite conservatives and libertarians and those who value the Constitution and the Bill of Rights is a love of liberty.
The way he delivered that line, too, I'm just like, come on. Yeah, that's who we really need to guarantee victory for our movement, is we need the Gary Johnson voters. That's who we
yeah.
need.
But the challenge for the right is no longer to unite conservatives and libertarians. Most libertarians in 2010, like I said, they've already found a way to make their libertarianism jive with American nationalism. Some have perverted to paleoconservatism, like the Pat Buchanan type, and then others have just jumped on the left with the Bernie craze and never looked back.
The Libertarian Party, the actual official National Libertarian Party, is basically just dem light at this point. They've got, like, you know, pink-haired feminists and transgenders sitting on their committees and whatnot. It's a total joke. It's basically a left-wing party now.
The only libertarians at CPAC are the cringe Cato nerds, and we don't want to unite with them. We want to drive them as far away from the GOP as fast as is humanly possible.
You know, in 2020, the New York Times reported that 60% of women named Karen voted for Joe Biden.
So this is seriously cringe. Like, anyone who understands the Karen meme knows that this was created by black people to basically mock white women that they consider problematic or racist. And it's just basically used as a bludgeon to attack all white women. It's kind of like if racist white people were to find a common black name, I don't know, Tamika, and just start calling every problematic black woman a Tamika.
A Central Park Tamika.
Yeah.
Just
yes.
Like a Central Park Karen.
Right, right. So it's a very, very racist term. And Cruz doesn't, I don't think he knows that. I think like a lot of people who are in their bubble, they don't understand. They're just completely oblivious to anti-white racism because they can't imagine a society in which white people aren't in charge.
The problem, too, is that, well, the Karen meme worked for a while because it was accurate, because we know Karens in our lives. We absolutely, I need to speak to your manager, like, that's, we know people like that, and we've encountered people like that. So memes that are based on reality, it's like some of the other white stereotype memes, like the meme of Kyle, you know, the meme of the white trash dude who drinks Monster Energy and yeah. likes to punch through drywalls. Like, those memes are effective because they are partially true. But yeah, like you said, Karen and some of the others are weaponized to be used as just anti-white racial terms.
Yeah, but the whole thing, like, I want to speak to the manager, that thing was created, that idea was created, but she wanted to speak to the manager because she wanted to complain about black people in the store. And then it was taken by white people who were oblivious to that. And they were like, oh, yeah, I know this woman who's this middle-aged white woman who's really annoying. She must be a Karen. She's always wanting to speak to the manager. But it was kind of taken by white people and made palatable to them so it wouldn't make them feel offended. And then they ran with it. And that's kind of, I think, where Cruz is at. So then the Karen thing that Cruz makes, it kind of ties into his entire speech was really, really bad. Like, I'm not nitpicking. If you go back and watch the entire speech, it was all over the place. Like, he made one line where he said, Bernie is wearing mittens and AOC is claiming that she was murdered. And it didn't really have anything to do with, like, what is Bernie's wearing mittens and AOC is claiming she was murdered? Because AOC is not claiming she was murdered.
Being weeks late to the meme. Like, it's just,
yeah, and it doesn't, he threw it in with a bunch of things that didn't make any sense. And it almost tried to sound like a mega church pastor. Like, that was the vibe he was trying to give him.
But I was also getting vibes of what is up, fellow kids. Like, I know memes too. That's basically what that was.
That's Cruz's whole thing is he's trying his best to sound cool to young people. And he made another line that was really outdated. He said that he was talking about how in California they were pouring sand into skate parks to stop people from skating because of COVID. And he said, the idea, the concept of liberty is profoundly subversive. And he was arguing that somewhere there's some 19-year-old skater kid who sees this and he's like, I'm going to join the libertarians because this mayor is deciding to stop me from skating. But
the only thing that the skater dudes and libertarians have in common is that they both love weed.
That's literally it. The thing is, back in 2010, in 2010, there were a few 19-year-old skater dudes around the country who were kind of apolitical. They were kind of rebellious. They were atheistic. And they would have been genuinely pissed off at the mayor pouring sand in their skate park. But nowadays, it's not like that. That doesn't exist. The skater dudes now have become totalitarians. Like, they're hardcore leftist, hardcore intersectionalist leftist, and so anything that the government tells them to do, they're going to bend, because this isn't the age of the rebellious 19-year-old skater dude. This isn't punk rock culture anymore. Like, this is 90s culture, and that Ted Cruz is trying to reference, and it just doesn't work. Like, Ted needs to retire and he needs to go work in a think tank. This is where he would best serve the calls of right-wing nationalism and constitutionalism. But moving on from cringe Cancun Cruz, yeah, we can argue that he's a little bit stale and outdated and all, but at least his heart is in the right place, which is not what we can say about a lot of the speakers at CPAC.